U.S. Army cannon heater and my Stirling engine in 2015, the last rendition of this here beer can engine. 48-inch blade, so she clears the rafters, a little bit over a 5-inch pitch on 3 blades there. Somewhere in the neighborhood of 1500 CFM at that RPM. Yep, U.S. Army cannon heater, number 20. Yep, so it's the big one. Anybody needs to know the dimensions on that. This is what it looks like. I made that crankshaft myself on my lathe and my milling machine. And then, because the engine itself doesn't even weigh anything, and that's a 5-pound barbell weight up there for a flywheel, including the fan, it tipped over, and my bearing holder is a old kick drum pedal from my bass drum on my drum set, and it cracked in half, and so now she's limping along. Anybody want us to do the math on this and figure out the horsepower? I'm figuring in the neighborhood I'm making somewhere between 35 and 75 watts. I know that's a range, but I got the only thing I can equate it to is a ceiling fan. Yeah. So where I was running two 20-inch fans down here in my basement. I don't know if you can see the pitch on that with me in the way here and all that. I am in the basement, but that's a substantial old curvature there. And I did all the reading I could do over at the big ass fan company on low speed, high volume, low pressure fans. And everything from everybody's propeller on an airplane to propellers on boats to try to figure out what I could do to do the math and figure out the horsepower. 6 inches down there, 2 1/4 in the power side. Yeah, and you can see I keep making brackets for it I keep breaking it, but yeah, and when it comes to a stop, the cardboard blades are in no danger because of the compression. It always stops in the same spot. So let me give it a spin. Yeah. Yeah. So if I take that off of there, it does near 350 RPM. However, with a 4-inch stroke, cast iron piston and all that flywheel, the flywheel is nowhere near big enough to hold that motor down. I have to bolt it to the stove to make it stay still. I put a bicycle wheel on there 18 inches and it went nuts. At least 350 RPM. And I figured it was going to blow up, but it didn't. So, yeah, but this is about the last rendition of the beer can thing, only because I'm tired of working with the kick drum pedal and the plywood and all the rest of that, and I have machine tools, and that's what it takes to make those parts up there. My milling machine and the lathe made that crankshaft, and it was a bunch straighter with near no runout until I dropped it on the floor. What else is new? Any questions? I'd be more than happy to discuss this. Thanks for watching.